I'm Dana K. White, and this is day 10 of 14 days to opening your front door to guests or having a home that's ready for the holidays. We're getting really, really close. And if you're freaking out, that's totally fine. If this is the first video that you have happened upon, please go watch the playlist. Start on day one so you can understand what it is that we're doing here, because we are not doing a let's get my house cleaned once and for all. We are doing something with a goal, which is be willing and able to let people in the front door or be able to take Christmas pictures and not be worried about what I'm going to accidentally get in the background. Here we go. You know what I want you to do first, right? I want you to do the dishes, set a timer for 5 minutes and go pick stuff up, wipe down all the major surfaces in your bathroom and sweep your kitchen. Because today is day 10 and we're getting to like the things that have to be done right before they come, okay? This is the day that you are going to finish your room prioritization worksheet. If you did not listen and didn't go back and listen to the first 9 days, and so you don't know what I'm talking about, the room prioritization worksheet is where we listed out the rooms in the house that guests are going to see prioritized according to how much time they are going to spend in those rooms, okay? We have made a checklist of things we want to get done in those rooms, and we have been checking stuff off of that list almost every day for the last, you know, lots of days. But today is the day to finish the list. So the first thing I want you to do is count how many more tasks you have left to do. And then look at your 14-day planning pages and just your day-to-day and also just your reality of today and figure out how much time you have to spend on this getting your house ready for guests today, okay? All right, so you've gotten it figured out. You know how much time you have. Let's say that you have 2 hours to spend, which is 120 minutes, and you counted all the tasks left on your room prioritization worksheet, and you have 30 tasks left, okay? So you're gonna do the math. Let's say 2 hours, 120 minutes, and 30 tasks. That's 4 minutes for each task. You need to have that figure in your mind. Some of these tasks are gonna take you 10 seconds, and you're gonna wish you would have done them 5 years ago. Some of them are going to be daunting and are gonna be like take you a lot longer than 4 minutes, but that's the amount of time that you have. And this is a reality check. A time is finite and it doesn't expand just because I want it to, okay? We are dealing in reality here. So I want you to work through this checklist knowing that you have 4 minutes per task. If something is 10 seconds, great. That means that you're gonna be okay when something else takes 5 minutes instead of 4 minutes, but keep working through. If you have 120 tasks and 120 minutes, and most of the tasks are gonna take 5 minutes each, you need to go ahead and say some of these things are not gonna get done, okay? Starting in the room where they're gonna spend the least time, just take some stuff off of the list, okay? We already had an adjustment day earlier where we really tried to think things through, but today is the day to plow through. Let me give you a little bit of warning. Let's say that you've set aside 6 hours today to work. Great, and you think, well, then I don't need to do any math. Do the math anyway, okay? You need to have that reality check. That reality check is so important because if it doesn't get done off of this list today, it's probably not going to get done because the next several days, we're gonna be working on the things to actually welcome people into our home, okay? These are the things that may or may not happen. If it doesn't happen today, it's not gonna happen, okay? So be realistic. And remember that super duper attention to detail, being amazingly thorough and doing everything perfectly so that you'll never have to do it again, yeah, that may be a luxury that you can't afford anymore, all right? Because you have a time limit and you have to get it done. If you get through everything on your room prioritization worksheet, start back at the top of the sheet, according to the room, this is the room where we spend the most time with our guests, and straighten. Make things look nice, straighten things up. Make sure this little thing is, you know, neat and nice. And just walk through the rooms, giving it one more look through, giving yourself time to make sure everything is nice and neat and the way you want it to be. Not that life isn't going to happen, but when life happens and your toddler pulls all the books off the bookshelf, that's going to be the thing to do, as opposed to that piling onto all the things you wish you would have gotten done before now. Okay. All right. If you would like to have the 14 days written out for you, all the instructions, plus all of the printable checklists that we talked about, the room prioritization worksheet, the 14-day planning pages. If you want all of that in a printable form, you can get the ebook, 14 Days to Opening Your Front Door to Guests, at aslobcomesclean.com/14, like the letter, I mean, like the number, 1414. Okay, just go there and use the code YouTube to get 50% off through the end of November. All right, get to checking things off that list. Have fun. See you tomorrow.